So the musculoskeletal system, as the name suggests, is made up of the bones that make up our skeleton and also the muscles that allow us to move.
Movement's really integral in everything that we do. And so to interact with our environment and to stand and move and walk. And it changes through growth and development, and it changes with pain when we're in pain.
I've been working on skeletal muscle for about 30 or 40 years, and recent years I've been looking how that translates to human disease.
Many problems can occur in the musculoskeletal system, and musculoskeletal disorders are probably the most common. They contribute to about 12% of the burden of disease in Australia, and they're very diverse, which sometimes makes them difficult to treat. So to treat musculoskeletal disorders, largely we design strategies using exercise or strength programs rather than pharmaceutical interventions.
So one of the key things that we're trying to do in the lab is to identify targets for new innovative treatments for people with painful musculoskeletal conditions. To really identify these targets, we need to understand the control of movement. We need to understand what is different in those people that have pain compared to those people who don't have pain. And so we're using some really innovative tools to try and understand more about the control of movement throughout development. The work that's being done in the lab at the moment is with children with cerebral palsy and also some children with a range of genetic disorders. And if we find out how our kids develop typically, and how the changes are different in kids with neuromotor disorders, then we can try to find some potential targets for interventions for kids that are perhaps struggling.
We've been developing compounds that may stabilise nerve muscle connections over time. Best case scenario is an understanding of how the molecules that maintain and connect motor nerves with muscle can be manipulated to basically strengthen nerve muscle connection in disease or in old age, to sort of improve people's ability to walk or move, or in the case of disease, to try and give them a better quality of life in terms of muscle strength.